بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت السميع العليم. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على عبدك ونبيك سيدنا محمد في الأولين وفي الآخرين وفي الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. Brothers and sisters, whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, nobody can misguide him. And whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala misguides, nobody can guide him back to the straight path. I bear witness and I testify that no deity worthy of our worship more than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I bear witness and I testify that Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his final messenger and his perfect worshipper. As to what follows, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, وَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ تِبْيَانًا لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةً وَبُشْرَى لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ. We send the scripture down to you, explaining everything, and as guidance and mercy and good news for those who devoted themselves to Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this beautiful ayah presents one of the most important features of this book, one of the most important features of the Quran, that this book has explained and made everything clear. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says everything, that means literally everything. And that's why we take it as a guide. And in this ayah exactly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you read, understand, and implement the Quran in your life, and if you are close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will receive good news. It's a great ayah with many different meanings. But the most important point here is, if the Quran, as we believe, has an explanation of everything, so let's wonder about, walk and move between the ayat, read them, understand them, and implement them in our lives. So I don't want to give you my thoughts, my ideas, my understanding, and my guidance of how to deal with the current situation. Let's put that between his hands, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's leave it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and let's listen to him, azza wa jal. Regarding the trials, the hardship that we live today, the pandemic, the disease, the challenge that we all face, let's listen to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He promised us full explanation, as we just mentioned in the first ayah, guidance, mercy, and also subhanahu wa ta'ala promised us good news. So when I opened the book, the Quran, I found Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about the trials in Surah Al-Baqarah, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. We shall certainly test you with fear, hunger, and loss of property, lives, and groups, but give good news for those who steadfast. So, based on this ayah, we know as a fact that we will be tested. It is a fact that we will be tested. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will watch us, will watch our hearts, azza wa jal, will watch our reactions and the reactions of our heart during the hardship, during the trial. So we know that as a fact. And only those who are patient and steadfast will receive good news from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to help ourselves to be among righteous people, we need to listen to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Hadid, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. ما أصاب من مصيبة في الأرض ولا في أنفسكم إلا في كتاب من قبل أن نبرأها إن ذلك على الله يسير لكي لا تأسوا على ما فاتكم ولا تفرحوا بما آتاكم والله لا يحب كل مختال فخور. No misfortune can happen either in the earth or in yourselves that was not set down in writing before we bring it into being. Indeed, it's easy for Allah, so that you may neither grieve on what has escaped you, nor over exult on what he has given to you. And Allah doesn't love any self-admirer over a proud. To stay calm, balanced, and stable, you need to remember that all what we experience today are in His hands, subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's His mashi'a, it is His will, it's His qadr to send us the trials. So don't be sad, don't be depressed, don't be scared, and also at the same time, don't be arrogant, don't be overproud. Don't be overconfident that you own everything and you can control everything and you have the ability to solve every single problem. Instead, show your weakness between His hands, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Repent to Allah Azza wa Jal and go back to Him. So from the first ayah we learned that the trial is coming for sure. And the second ayah tells us, when you face that trial, don't be sad, don't be scared, don't be depressed, don't be arrogant, don't be overproud, overconfident. What you need to do, you need to be stable and calm and submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you realize this, then Surah Ash-Shura would tell you something very important that you need to know. وَمَا أَصَابَكُم مِّن مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ وَيَعْفُ عَنْ كَثِيرٍ. Whatever hardship befalls you is because of what your own hands have committed, while He overlooks many of your faults. So what we experience today is a direct result of the sins that we've committed, our heedlessness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and being preoccupied with this world rather than the Lord of the world. This is what we deserve, this is justice. But we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to deal with us with His mercy before His justice azza wa jal. So what really defines how this test, this pandemic, this trial, this illness is good for us or not, is how we respond to it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. وَبَلَوْنَاهُمْ بِالْحَسَنَاتِ وَالسَّيِّئَاتِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. We've tested them with the prosperity and adversity, so perhaps they would return. And He says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَلَوْلَا إِذْ جَاءَهُمْ بَأْسُنَا تَضَرَّعُوا. If only they learned the humility when suffering came from us. So the reason of why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends His forces to people, whether they are viruses, earthquakes, hardships, or variety of disasters or blessings, all with one clear reason, with one clear purpose, to remind people to go back to Him Azza wa Jal, to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And finally remember, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, وَإِن يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍّ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُوَ. If Allah touches you with affliction, no one can remove it except Him. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us for a reason. Created us subhanahu wa ta'ala with a clear purpose to be khulafa. This is the major task, this is the major responsibility, to guide ourselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to guide others to Allah azza wa jal. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with His hikmah, with His will, with His wisdom, He granted us with all the blessings and the ni'am around us to help us to do that. Those are tools. So it doesn't make sense that we spend our lives busy with the tool on the expense of the ultimate goal. Dear brothers and sisters, this fleeting life of this dunya has preoccupied us from the Lord. It has filled our hearts with love and devotion to it. However, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us this global lesson to remind us to go back to Him Azza wa Jal, to be totally devoted to Him Azza wa Jal. I always hear time after time again that this materialistic lifestyle takes us away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But with this trial, things changed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted us today with a lot of time where you can sit home alone, reflect and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Build your relationship with Allah azza wa jal. Repent to Him. Shed off materialism. Leave everything behind your back. Become devoted to His love. And again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَبَلَوْنَاهُمْ بِالْحَسَنَاتِ وَالسَّيِّئَاتِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ We've tested them with the prosperity and adversity, so perhaps they would return. So let's show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala how we worship Him at the time of trial and hardship. Let's return to Him. Let's take the advantage to overcome materialism and to enjoy the direct relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's make that time the best time ever. The time of isolation, when you started to experience, your heart started to experience the sweetness feeling of the closeness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِنِّي دَاعٍ فَأَمِّنُهُ اللَّهُمَّ لَكَ الْحَمْدُ وَلَكَ الشُّكْرُ أَنْتَ قَيُّومُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَمَنْ فِيهِنَّ اللَّهُمَّ لَكَ الْحَمْدُ وَلَكَ الشُّكْرُ أَنْتَ قَيُّومُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَمَنْ فِيهِنَّ اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على عبدك ونبيك سيدنا محمد في الأولين والآخرين وفي الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين اللهم إنا نسألك بأسمائك الحسنى وصفاتك العلى وباسمك العظيم الأعظم الذي إذا دعيت به أجبت وإذا سئلت به أعطيت نسألك بأن نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت وحدك لا شريك لك وأن محمدا عبدك ونبيك ورسولك نسألك ربنا بأنك أنت الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم الحي القيوم الرب الرحمن الرحيم مالك الملك ذو الجلال والإكرام نسألك يا واحد يا أحد يا فرد يا صمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد يا حنان يا منان يا حنان يا منان يا حنان يا منان اللهم إنا نسألك رحمتك نسألك رحمتك ونسألك عفوك ونسألك عفوك اللهم إنا نسألك موجبات رحمتك وعزائم مغفرتك ونسألك شكر نعمتك وحسن عبادتك ونسألك قلبا سليما ولسانا صادقا ولسانا صادقا ونسألك يا ربنا من خير ما تعلم ونستغفرك لما تعلم إنك أنت علام الغيوب اللهم ارفع عنا الوباء والبلاء اللهم ارفع عنا الوباء والبلاء اللهم ارفع عنا الوباء والبلاء اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا اللهم ان كان ما اصابنا وما حل بنا بما كسبت أيدينا فتب علينا واغفر لنا وارحمنا وأنت الرحمن الرحيم وأنت الرحمن الرحيم اللهم إن كان ما أصابنا هو بانتشار المعصية والسكوت عليها فإنا نستغفرك ونتوب إليك نستغفرك ونتوب إليك اللهم إن كان من بيننا عصاة فاعف عنهم ولا تشملنا بغضبك إن كان من بيننا عصاة فاعف عنهم ولا تشملنا بغضبك وإن كان من بيننا صالحا صادقا مخلصا يرضيك فاشملنا معه برحمتك فاشملنا معه برحمتك اللهم ربنا اللهم ربنا أصابنا جندي من جنودك أصابنا جندي من جنودك فعجزت به الدول وحارت فيه العقول وعجزت عنه الحيل فانقطعت بنا السبل وسدت الأبواب وانقطعت الأسباب وليس لنا إلا أنت وليس لنا إلا أنت اللهم ما عصيناك جهلا بمقامك ولا استخفافا بقدرك وحاشاك ولكن سولت لنا أنفسنا معاصي فاقترفناها فتب علينا وارحمنا فتب علينا وارحمنا اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا اللهم إنا نستغفرك من انشغالنا عنك بالدنيا الغرور نستغفرك من انشغالنا عنك بالدنيا الغرور نستغفرك من غفلتنا عنك نستغفرك من غفلتنا عنك ونستغفرك من كل ذنب ونتوب إليك ربنا إنا مسنا الضر وأنت أرحم الراحمين ربنا إنا مسنا الضر وأنت أرحم الراحمين، لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين، لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. يا رحيم يا رحمن، يا رحيم يا رحمن، يا حي يا قيوم، يا حي يا قيوم، يا حنان يا منان، يا حنان يا منان، يا حنان يا منان، يا قهار يا جبار، يا قهار يا جبار، يا حي يا قيوم، برحمتك نستغيث، برحمتك نستغيث، برحمتك نستغيث. يا غارة الله جد السير مسرعة، يا غارة الله، يا رحمة الله جد السير مسرعة، يا رحمة الله، يا رحمة الله، يا عفو الله، يا عفو الله. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين، وصل اللهم على سيدنا محمد في الأولين والآخرين وفي الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. وجزاكم الله خيرا، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.